ladies. I mean, what are y'all in a cult? I mean, no hair at all.
What up? It's the Trooper.
Here's a very important tip from your Uncle Trooper. This is not a poker tip. It's not a Vegas tip. It's a life tip. If you're wearing a backpack and you're in public or whatever, you should be mindful that you're wearing a backpack. So when you move and you turn and shit, remember that you have the fucking thing on, because the next person that hits me with their backpack is gonna get a permanent dent in the back of their fucking skull. Everybody who's scouring my vlogs for complaints, that's a complaint. It's a complaint that grown fucking adults can be so oblivious and inconsiderate. And if you don't like it, I'm sure there are plenty of videos on YouTube about rainbows and sunshine and fucking unicorns. Yo, I was originally gonna go do something different and play at Luxor. I think the Kraut is gonna be there tonight, but they have no game. So, I guess I'm not gonna play there. Usually I get to the strip and then the mood strikes me and I figure out where I wanna play. I think tonight I'm gonna go check out Harrah's. A little bit of extra walking, maybe I could use that, but really, I'm just gonna walk in and see what the games look like. They have 3 games going at the moment, so. That little flamingo walkthrough action. Harrah's is running a promotion right now that requires 80 hours in a month, and they're giving away World Series seats and whatever in the free roll tournament, or the tournament that you win your way, you get your way into. That could mean that these games are, you know, a free roll fuckfest like last night. That's my new term. I like it. We're gonna take a look anyway. So I walked in the poker room there at Harrah's, and 2 things made me not really want to play there. Number one, the mood just isn't right. The other reason is that the tables are pretty much full of guys that look like they've been trying to win their way into a free roll into the World Series of Poker for about 40 years and have just keep failing. So I'm gonna go over to Caesar's. So I've got an idea. You guys tell me how you feel about this. I think I'm gonna do something like really different, and maybe for like a week or 2 weeks, focus on rooms that are off the strip. Maybe South Point, Red Rock, of course, I haven't been there in a while. Green Valley Ranch, maybe even Boulder Station if there's a game. That can't be a bad game. Let me tell you this, if there's a no limit game at Boulder Station, there's no way that can be a bad game. And by bad game, I mean loaded with good players who are like, you know, tough to beat or whatever. There's just no way. Who the fuck would go to Boulder Station and play, right? I don't know. Tell me what you guys think of that. I might actually start that tomorrow. It might be too late to get your answer after, before I start it, but I will pay attention to the responses. Let me know what you think of it. Not that I need a reason to get another coffee, but I didn't sleep very well last night, so why not? Spiral escalators are cool, no? I don't know if these dudes always look like this, but he looks like he smells that shitty sewer smell. Oh no, he just got that look on his face like he smells something not right. I think someone with some pull must have watched one of my vlogs, because the poo-poo smell, I don't really smell it today. All right, I'm not gonna do a lot of inspecting of the quality of these games. I'm just gonna take a seat if they have it, see how it goes. I'm not afraid to leave after a couple orbits if it sucks. Worst game ever at Caesars. I'm actually kind of enjoying it a little bit, but hey, no matter how good the game is, sometimes you gotta get up and go pee. My friends, that is going to bring us to the end of another session of poker in the city of, actually this is paradise. We're not even in the city of Las Vegas. Did you know that? You probably did. Hey lady, you got your boob out. I don't know if you know that. They got one boob out each. What's up with that? Three boobs. Looking like some damn petrified strippers. That's funny, petrified, you know, kind of because they're like stone, but maybe they were wood at one point or some shit because they're like ancient. What? I don't know what I'm talking about. Listen, it done got cold out here. So the game tonight was rather interesting, to be honest with you. It was pretty decent too. By the way, I won $379, and there was a couple memorable hands. One hand that I did not get on video was I limped in with pocket threes and we saw like a five-way flop. It's 3-6-7 with two spades. And this dude led out for 12. So I called 12. It might have been 15. It was 12 or 15. And when the action got over to the button, it was either the cutoff or the button, he raised it to like 100. Maybe even a little bit more, like 105 or 110 or some shit. So I had a little more than 300 to start the hand, and our stacks were very close to the same. He had a little more than 200 behind. And so when it came back to me, it's like, just the who the player was, it wasn't that hard to see that he had 4 or 5 and flop the straight. The only real decision I had was whether or not it was worth it to call to try to pair the board, and it definitely wasn't. I mean, so I folded the set. It was so clear he had 4 or 5, and he showed the 4 or 5. The other notable hand I did happen to video, so I limped in with ace 3 of diamonds, and we saw like a 6-way limp pot, 5 or 6 ways, and the flop was ace 3-3. So I flopped the fucking boat, right? Most of the time, I would, if there was a raise pre-flop, I would have let out. Most of the time I would bet, but this time I didn't. I checked. I was like second to act post flop or whatever. And the next guy to act bet 10, and it folded back around to me. And by the way, there were two hearts on the flop. He bet 10, and I just called 10. And when the turn came out, a blank, like not a heart. I mean, obviously I already have a fucking boat. I'm saying though, it wasn't the heart. I did something that a lot of people do when they're drawing to a flush and they're first to act. I tanked about it for a minute and then I checked. People do that when they're trying to make you think that they actually have something. They're trying to get you to be careful and bet small or maybe just check or whatever. They're basically trying to misrepresent their hand and project that they don't have a flush draw. So I did that, because that's what people with a flush draw do. Because I want them to think I have a flush draw, because I want to miss the flush and then bluff at it. You know what I mean? So, I tank checked the turn and he bet 15. It was such a small bet that it worried me that my whole entire tactics were gonna be for nothing, right? I call the 15 and that puts about 60 in the pot. And the river comes out like a complete blank, like an eight of spades or something. And by the way, no matter what the river is, whether it's a heart or not a heart, I am going to overbet. I already know what I'm gonna do. I knew what I was gonna do when I called the flop. You know what I mean? I'm like, if he bets the turn, I know he's gonna fall for me being on a flush draw. I'm gonna overbet the river, even if the heart comes. So I know I'm risking like getting more money into the pot, but I'm out of position. And after the turn comes out, I'm only like 22% to hit the heart, right? So that would make me like 78% to have a favorable card on the river, which is basically anything but a heart. And the overbet is gonna get paid. At least I'm thinking that's what's gonna happen. So it comes like an eight of spades, and I tank for a minute and I bet 80. I really should have bet like 90. I think you would have called 90. I think I bet too small. There's only 60 in the pot. And if I'm gonna overbet the pot, I should overbet it by a bit more. I think 120 would have been too much. I think he would have just given it up. He only put in 10 on the flop and 15 on the turn. But the 80, and I think maybe the 90, would have been enough for him to want to win the pot and want to risk that much. He thought for about 15 seconds and called. And of course, I had him crushed. So that was, I love when overbets work out. I mean, I was gonna overbet no matter what. If the heart comes and I overbet, he might be confused by that and still call. I tell you what, if a heart came, I probably would have bet like 150 or some crazy number like that, because it's less likely he's gonna call anyway, so I might as well make it big the few times that he does call. At least that's my thinking. What the fuck do I know? I really hope I parked at Bally's. I did, I parked at Bally's. I didn't park on the top floor though. What? Trooper, what's wrong with you? Why you park on a floor besides the top floor? What happened? Don't worry about that. I got a reason though. So what are they saying? I should not try to exit when the doors are closed? Man, I'm so glad they told me that. Holy shit, I was about to fuck up. I don't know what else to tell you tonight. Remember, if you like my videos, please do click the thumbs up button. Who am I talking to? No, there's nobody there. I'm talking to you. Click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos. Leave a comment down below. Yo, see you next time.